Hello everyone, and I'm Dr. Rashmi Sarkar. I'm a senior professor in dermatology in New Delhi, and I have a special interest in pigmentary disorders, especially melasma. So I'm going to talk about melasma today to you. First of all, melasma, what is it? Well, this is a pigmentary disorder of the skin and which appears as brown blotches on the skin. Now, both sides of the face is usually involved, which includes the cheeks, the forehead, the nose, the upper side of the lip, as well as the chin. So it depends. Some can have mild melasma, moderate or severe melasma, and it's quite common in women. Melasma is also called chelasma, which is the mask of pregnancy, and these are due to the hormonal fluctuations which occurs in pregnant women. Now, regarding the causes of melasma, this is complex. First of all, a person has to be genetically predisposed. So what happens is that there is a an overproduction of melanin or the pigment cells, and these are taken up either by the keratinocytes, epidermal melanosis, or deposited in the dermis, which is the dermal melanosis, in cells called the melanophages. The second cause is hormonal changes. So this can occur both due to pregnancy, due to fluctuation of hormones, or in a person who's taking oral contraceptive pill, or in some kind of a hormonal disorder. Sun exposure is quite important. The ultraviolet rays of the sun, as well as sometimes the heat production or even the visible light, can cause melasma. In fact, recently it has been said that even photoaging can be a part of melasma. Regarding medications, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs and anticonvulsants play a role, and cosmetics of all kinds can also sometimes lead to melasma. You need to ask your dermatologist and a qualified dermatologist for that. Now we come finally to the treatments of melasma. Yes, melasma can be treated to at least keep the pigmentation at a very low. But remember, it's almost a lifelong treatment. First of all, remember that melasma has to be treated by sunscreens. So, a broad spectrum sunscreen with an SPF of at least 30 is very, very important. You have to use it throughout the day on the face, and that containing physical sunscreens too. Next is topical therapies for melasma. So remember that hydroquinone, which is a cream, is actually the gold standard, but again has to be prescribed by your qualified dermatologist. So hydroquinone in combination with tretinoin and other agents, even topical steroids, again under your dermatologist supervision, is something that is used and has to be monitored by your dermatologist. Other skin lightening agents, like there is niacinamide, there is azelaic acid, kojic acid, and so many other agents are also important for, you know, helping you to clear melasma. The second line treatment, of course, remains chemical peels, which have to be done by your dermatologist for exfoliation and removal of the layers of the skin with the pigment. So peels like glycolic acid, salicylic acid, these are what your dermatologist is going to do. Last and third line, again under very qualified dermatologist, what can be used is for deep dermal melasma, and that is laser therapy. Remember, this is little difficult in dark skin, and what you can use is probably laser toning, and this again has to be done by your dermatologist. So these are some of the treatments. Remember that even camouflage cream, and there are certain oral agents now under dermatological supervision like tranexamic acid, which can be also given to the patient. But remember that you should never self-medicate, or you will end up with a lot of side effects of the drugs, especially with OTC drugs, like the side effects of topical steroids. So always under a qualified dermatologist supervision. So finally, what are the different types of melasma? The different types of melasma are, first of all, epidermal melasma. Epidermal melasma is one which is well-defined border, has a dark brown color, And with the Wood's lamp, it appears more obvious, and on dermoscopy, you see brown reticular network with dark brown granules, and usually has a good response to treatment. The next would be the dermal melasma, which has ill-defined borders with light brown, grayish to blue-gray color. Wood's lamp does not show any accentuation, and dermoscopy shows a reticuloglobular pattern with telangiectasia and archiform structure. This does not respond very well to treatment. Mixed melasma, this is a combination for both, so it could have blue-gray areas, light and dark brown colors. Mixed pattern is seen with the Wood's lamp and the dermatoscope, and on treatment there's a partial improvement. Well, what are the myths about melasma? Only pregnant women get melasma. This is not true. Melasma can affect both women as well as men of all ages and in all stages of life. Also, melasma goes away on its own. Well, even if this happens, this is very slow, so you do need to be treated by your qualified dermatologist. Also, you can't reduce the appearance of melasma. You can definitely lighten your melasma with treatment options, but remember, this is a treatment which is lifelong. So please remember to visit your qualified dermatologist nearby, and also stay at home, stay safe. Please take care of your skin. Thank you very much.